Hello, I'm Dr. Ian Strawford. I'm a cosmetic doctor and medical director of the Skin Excellence Clinics. And I'm going to tell you about a revolutionary new treatment that we've been using in the clinic for the last year called polynucleotides, or PDRN. This is a fantastic treatment and I'd love to tell you more.
What are polynucleotides?
Well, polynucleotides come from DNA. They are fragments of DNA. All of our DNA is made of strands of polynucleotides. You may have heard them called RNA. And in this case, this is the sequencing of polynucleotides from DNA that is actually the sequence that has a very powerful impact on the cells within the skin and the collagen-producing cells called fibroblasts. So let me explain polynucleotides in more detail, because people get concerned when we start to talk about DNA and DNA therapy. So polynucleotides are protein molecules that have unique codes. Effectively, I see them as messenger codes. So on your DNA, my DNA, every animal has DNA in our cells. And that DNA is made up of strands of polynucleotides, RNA, which actually have a function in telling other cells what to do. And so we've identified the unique codes that are telling those fibroblast skin cells what to do, and also telling stem cells, which circulate in our body, to make new fibroblast cells. So effectively, we're aiming with this treatment to increase the activity of fibroblast cells and the body to produce new fibroblast cells. And it's done by increasing the cell turnover. We know through the aging process that the turnover of cells slow down. So specifically within fibroblast cells, normally the cell life cycle is about 3 weeks. And it's the new cells are producing a lot of collagen and elastin, those structural components within the skin that maintain the skin's support, the elasticity and the tension of our skin and the health of our skin. Now, those cells on that three-week turnover, as we age, unfortunately, the cell cycle turns over longer. So they may only be active for the first 2 or 3 weeks, but then the presence of an inactive cell is there for a number of weeks afterwards. And that length of inactivity of that cell progresses with age. And the problem is that for a good period of time, then the cells are not producing collagen and elastin. And they're not being replaced by new cells until they finally die. So with polynucleotides, we're able to speed up the cell turnover back to get them back to that healthy 3 week cycle producing collagen and elastin, and then dying and new cells are being produced. So we're producing new cells and making our cells more active. And the net result is we see a gradual increase in the amount of collagen and elastin in the skin. So we're effectively making the skin more youthful again. This is truly regenerative medicine, cellular regenerative medicine.
How are they used?
So we can use polynucleotides in lots of ways. They were developed initially for tissue repair to help patients with chronic tissue, skin injuries, skin grafts, skin burns, and in medicine in general that way. And so we're using that harnessing power of that regenerative therapy. So we can use them where we want to sort of make the skin more youthful, where we want to increase the collagen, the elastin, the elasticity, the tone. So we use them in the face, the neck, but they can be used anywhere on the body. They're particularly helpful where we have damaged skin. That could be damage through the aging process or excessive ultraviolet light over the years. It could be scarring or acne scarring particularly. We can see the skin rejuvenate and regenerate following these treatments.
What age benefits the most from polynucleotides?
Polynucleotides can be used at any age, okay? From young patients, young adults maybe, where we're treating acne and acne scarring, okay? They reduce inflammation at the same time as repairing the tissues. So particularly good results with acne and acne scarring. They can be used in other scars, maybe surgical scars. We can get scars to remodel and change. they are invaluable in my book for anti-aging. And a lot of my patients with very damaged skin in later years of life, perhaps from sun damage, where really there's not a lot of options to rejuvenate their skin, polynucleotides can certainly give some benefits in changing the skin and rejuvenating the skin. So really any age.
Can they be combined with other treatments?
They definitely work well when they're combined with other treatments. And I particularly like combining them with some of my energy-based treatments. So with energy-based treatments, we're trying to stimulate the skin cells to produce new collagen and elastin, tightening the skin, remodeling the skin, and addressing aging and scarring, etc. When we pre-treat the skin with polynucleotides, we increase the cellular activity, we increase the number of cells, and thus the skin becomes much more responsive to those energy-based treatments. It's like we're making the skin more youthful again. And we know when we treat younger patients with energy-based treatments, maybe in your 30s and 40s, they respond really well to those treatments. When you get into your 50s and 60s and 70s, you definitely become less responsive to those treatments like Morpheus 8 or Tixul or laser resurfacing, etc. But if we pre-treat the skin and make it more youthful, then we get a much better response. So absolutely, they work great in combination, and we've seen some lovely results in combining them together.
Is the treatment painful?
So a lot of people worry about the pain, the treatment being painful. We have to inject the skin. We can inject polynucleotides deeper down if we're wanting to create some more structure, maybe to the ligaments and around those sort of areas within the face. But if we want to see the skin change itself, we need to inject the skin. And by doing that, we can get the best results within the skin. However, that would be painful if we didn't pre-treat the patient or administer a local anesthetic cream or even inject some anesthesia in to block the nerves. But yes, so we can make it a comfortable procedure when we've used appropriate analgesia. And most of our patients find it very tolerable.
Are they safe? And what is the downtime after the treatment?
So patients worry about polynucleotides. When we hear about cell therapy or regenerative therapy or DNA therapy, people worry about the safety. So let's talk where these polynucleotides come from. They could be accessed from any DNA, from any human or animal DNA. They found that an easy source of DNA that is not controversial is to obtain it from fish sperm. And specifically in this case, the ones I use from salmon sperm, which is freely available from farmed salmon that are not being harmed in any way and are part of the food chain anyway. And that DNA is a fantastic source of very pure RNA for the polynucleotides that we're using here. They've been shown to be very, very safe. In fact, they have almost no side effects that we're aware of at all, and they do not promote any abnormal cellular activity. Specifically, they do not promote the increased risk of a skin cancer or melanoma. In fact, they actually stabilize melanocyte cells. These are the pigment cells in our body. So we often see when patients are treated with polynucleotides, pigmentation issues can improve, and equally that in itself is offering a protective role, I think, from skin cancers. I think by making the skin more youthful and protecting the skin, actually it probably maybe reducing the risk of future skin cancers, although that's not been proven.
And what was the downtime after treatment?
So there's a little bit of downtime following treatment. As I said, we inject into the skin, which creates some little tiny bumps of the skin. And I find that those little bumps of the skin, the polynucleotides spread within the skin very quickly, but the little bumps can take a little while to go down. Maybe a few days in most people. In older patients, in thinner skin, it can take a little bit longer. But these little these small bumps in the skin, they're not red or itchy or uncomfortable. And most patients find that they can tolerate them quite well. And it certainly doesn't stop patients having a course of treatment.
How many treatments are needed?
So, how many treatments are needed? Well, we find that maybe in younger patients that one or two treatments may show a significant benefit to the to increasing the collagen, the elasticity of the skin. In older patients, if we're reversing more significant skin damage through aging, sun damage, or if we're treating scarring patients, acne scarring, usually three or four treatments are needed. And we try to do those treatments fairly close together, every 3 to 4 weeks. So we're speeding up that cell cycle turnover and we're maximizing the benefits. And we're seeing progressive changes from each treatment when we do that.
Is there a maintenance treatment?
So yes, maintenance is important when we've had these treatments. With a lot of our treatments, we're producing new, healthier skin, new collagen, new elastin, but that doesn't stay forever. And it probably lasts between 6 and 12 months in most people. So they may then start reverting back to the pre-treatment situation. So actually we find that if we plan a maintenance treatment protocol, which in older patients may mean having the polynucleotides, the PDRN, every 4 to 6 months, that seems to maintain good skin health. In younger patients, it may be once a year is appropriate.
Can polynucleotides help with hair growth?
Definitely polynucleotides can help with hair growth. So they can be injected into the scalp, and polynucleotides, in the same way they speed up the cell turnover of fibroblast skin cells, they certainly can speed up the turnover and stimulate the hair follicle cells that produce our hair. And so we can see an increase in hair density and an increase in the growth of the hair cycle. So if people are losing hair, either women maybe losing hair, which is very common as you enter into the menopause and afterwards, and men, obviously with male pattern baldness, can start losing hair. And it can be another way of invigorating the scalp growth and hair growth through simple injections. In fact, they're an alternative to platelet-rich plasma, or PRP, that we've used for many years, injected into the scalp. And I think that polynucleotides probably are a more powerful alternative to PRP itself. So great for people who are losing hair, great to stimulate hair growth before and after hair transplantation.